Hi, this is Kurt with Traverse Tool Company. Today we're going to talk about magnetic holding systems made by Noga. Let's jump right into this and talk about our number one best-selling indicator holder. By a wide margin, we sell way more of these than our number two. So let's talk about the features on it. We'll begin at the top. You see how this moves a little bit? This is a fine adjustment that's at the top of the indicator. I prefer the top fine adjustment more than the bottom, which I'll talk about in a moment, because these needles move just a slight amount. So the fine adjustment at the top just moves that just a little bit. We also have them available with the fine adjustment at the bottom, but then the whole arm moves, which means there's going to be a lot of movement. So it's not so much a fine adjustment, but a pretty big one when it's down there. So that's why I prefer the top fine adjustment better. Let's see, what's next? You can see this little lever down here that actually turns the magnet on and off. So you turn the magnet off, picks up real easily, turn it on. Of course, it's on a metal toolbox, so it's sticking right to it. So that's how easy that magnet works. We have a clamp that'll hold a dovetail. Might be able to see that dovetail in there. It holds a 8mm shank and a 3/8 shank, all in the same clamp. And you probably saw me loosen on this. So this is what tightens everything. So you have all these knuckles and this one screw that tightens everything up. So you don't have multiple screws you have to tighten to get it into position. So it makes for very easy, very quick setup. Not only that, but they obviously twist in here. Well, you notice the slot in here? They twist, but it'll only go so far, so you have to move that slot so that it'll move up into that and give you a lot more adjustability. But as loose as this thing is, moves around kind of all over the place, just tighten that screw and it's solid. So what if our best seller isn't quite big enough for you? I'm glad you asked because I have some great news. Look at this guy. So this is the same holder as our best seller, but on steroids. All the features are the same. In fact, the clamp on the end is exactly the same part. The magnet on the bottom holds almost 300 pounds on that little magnet. Can you believe that? So it's going nowhere. The clamp on here is so much more robust. So again, you might have to pivot that knuckle to get it to move. But look at the reach this thing has. It's huge. The magnet at the bottom works just the same. In fact, they all do. Anything that's switchable moves just by the switch of that lever. So look at this little fella. So if you have a real tight spot to get into and you can't put our big guy or even that best-selling indicator holder into that space, we offer these. And it is small, but a couple of disadvantages to keep it down to this size is that the clamp will only hold a dovetail or an 8mm shank would go in there. There's no fine adjustment on it. This knob is to tighten the indicator, not a fine adjustment. And the magnet has no on-off switch, so it's always just on. But other than that, it works the same, has plenty of adjustability on it, and when it locks up, it's solid, except for the fact that that magnet doesn't have quite as much pull on it because of the fact that it'll never turn off. Here's a couple other little guys that have something a little bit different about them. First, though, I want to talk about something that's not different, which is the way this holds the 3/8 shank. We didn't see that on the other ones, but this is just to show you how that works. A drop indicator has a 3/8 shank on it, so that's how that's held. And this one also has the same thing for 3/8 and a dovetail. Okay, so they're pretty small. fair amount of holding power. In fact, this one has 70 pounds, which is quite substantial for a magnet that small. So what's all this stuff down at the bottom of these? Well, I'm glad you asked, because it's kind of pretty cool, actually. If you loosen it, you can pivot these without having to loosen the whole arm, and it pivots around very evenly. Well, there's another purpose for it too. If you watch the top of this, as I tighten, it's a fine adjustment. It's not really that fine of an adjustment because it is at the bottom, so the whole arm swings back and forth when you make that adjustment. So the little movement on the end of the needle is going to be quite a lot. And again, that's why I like the fine adjustment at the top. But these are another pretty neat option that Noga has. Another nice feature about any of them that have the magnetic switchable base on them is the contour on the bottom of them. So the reason for that contour is to put it on something round, for example, a lathe chuck or a milling machine spindle or anything that's got a curve on it. As you can see, Noga makes a pretty good variety of indicator holders, and we have even more available than we were talking about here today. So if you have any questions about something you need to do with your next project, give us a call and we can help you with that.